Hey, what's up everybody, my name is TrophyNut and welcome back to The Witcher 3 on the That Much difficulty. We're still at the Chameleon. We're almost done with final preparations. We doubled our amount of sorceresses we have at our disposal because of Philippa and Margarita joining us. And now we only have Avallac'h left to talk to, so he took the major suite here. And he's sitting on the bed over there. So, hello, Avallac'h. What do you need us for? If I can talk to him. Because Avallac'h has something really cool in mind.
I never expected this of you.
You humans have unusual tastes.
How do you unusual tastes?
Need to ask? You're a sage.
I ask as a courtesy. A concept you clearly forgot when you left without uttering a word.
Ciri was in a hurry.
I know. So she wrote in her letter. But that is not my concern. You eliminated Imlareth adeptly. So adeptly, you might say you inspired me.
Interesting. Tell me right away.
Meaning?
The loss of one of his great generals has weakened Eridan significantly. Two others remain.
How do we get rid of them?
Caranthir is a loyalist, but Gels, that is another story. He was a devoted follower of our former king. And as it happens, Eridan poisoned our beloved ruler.
But that is extremely new news, because if Gels is truly that loyal to the previous king and he finds out that Eridan killed that man, well, that elf, we might be able to persuade Gels to switch sides. So who knows this?
You make it sound important. So, guess it's not exactly common knowledge.
I'd even call it a secret.
How do you manage to hide it?
Oh, I assure you, he's excellent at covering his tracks, though not terribly subtle. But I'm even better at uncovering them.
Okay, sounds fair. So, do you think we can make a deal with Gels, then?
Haven't mentioned killing Gels.
Such drastic means are not always necessary.
So, you probably plan to offer him a deal.
Brilliant deduction. Bravo.
Oh, God, I hate his patronizing tone. So, I'd rather kill Gels than make a deal, but no. We're mostly up for a less lethal option, so what do you intend to do?
Fine. So what do you propose?
Why, to bring Gels here. Show him the truth of what happened.
Fabulous plan, if we only knew where to find him.
We do. In the land of the NL.
Okay, well, let's make Avallac'h explain what the Land of the NL is exactly, so we also know.
Land of the NL?
You don't recall. After all, you did travel with Eridan for some time.
Because Geralt was Elder, part of the Red Riders, the Wild Hunt, for a while.
Centuries ago, a world that is now our home. The Red Riders come from there. And it is there where we will find Gels.
When he was looking for Ciri, Geralt was part of the Wild Hunt for a while, so, but he lost his memory after that, so what do you mean, how do you mean
to get
there? You're
forgetting something. You and Ciri might know how to travel between worlds, but me? Not so much.
You clearly know there are many other worlds apart from the one where we now stand. They're linked by passages, hidden gateways that afford travel from one world to another. Of course, few know of these gateways. Even fewer can locate them.
Elven sages, for example?
For example. One such passage will open soon near where we are, fortuitously enough. Between this noble edifice and the butcher's yard. That's our chance. Shall we go?
Sounds like a plan. I don't know if we need to prepare for this, but let's go now.
Let's go. I know this house. Supposed to drive a godling from here.
Supposed to?
Decided it was harmless.
So this is the house where Corinne Tilly still lives, along with Sarah the godling. And well, I was talking about if we should prepare, because I don't know if a witcher with all his swords is prepared to take on a world where there's, well, more technology as the one we're in right now. Because I don't think Geralt will be able to do anything against the machine gun. Yes, indeed. Pretty hard to miss, is it?
This is the place. Once we enter, there'll be no returning until we reach Geralt's. Ready?
Yes, let's go.
Remember, wherever you land, search for a place that looks like this one. We shall meet sooner or later.
Mean we'll be separated?
It's possible. I lack your ward's talent. Zirel is the lady of time and space. I merely know how to use this arcane knowledge to a limited degree. It's time.
So, because this is a portal through space and time, the differences between Geralt and Avallac'h entering the portal might mean that there's a bigger or smaller difference when both of them end up at the other side. Final preparations completed because we started the last side quest for that. Well, sub-quest, not really a side quest. So, this is actually a pretty cool quest because we go to other worlds. It's the only one where we actually go to other worlds. For some reason, I'm overburdened, says the game. And I think that is, again, because...
Welcome to the Dido-wet Desert.
There's somewhere in our world.
Ever
yeah.
seen such
canyon? Fuck, this is going to be annoying.
Come, you must go.
I'm going to see if I can solve this. It's because I think we had that once before in Vizima when we don't have access to Roach.
A very old world, thoroughly raped and destroyed.
We lose our extra carry weight.
Mainly desert creatures, able to survive months on end without water. Oh, and large sand crabs beneath the surface.
Great.
We must be careful.
So we have saddlebags equipped. And as you can see on the top there, we're not really overburdened as the game tells us we are. Which makes this even harder to fix, though. I can drop this. Let's drop a few of these things.
They don't sense us.
It's not the end of the world.
And before?
Okay, now we can walk again. Okay, great.
Or elves?
Do you believe humanoids have a monopoly on destroying worlds?
So what did live here? Sentient monsters of some sort?
Look at those cliffs. Remind you of anything?
Look a bit like the bed of a giant river.
Or the bottom of a sea.
Mean there were water creatures here once?
No creatures. Merely a sea.
Trying to say that...
That there are many different worlds and even more forms of life. Many of them intelligent, much more so, in fact, than you humans. But as it turns out, not even that could stop them from exhausting all the resources of their world. To the last drop.
So, something caused all the water to disappear from this world. And look at those fancy rings up there. I don't seem to be able to run at my own accord yet.
Ah. The portal.
Looks more like a ruin.
Appearances can be deceiving.
So what are we waiting for?
For it to open. Shouldn't take but a few moments.
But in the meantime, just take some precautions.
What's going on?
The sand crabs have sensed our presence.
Wonderful.
Okay. Kill monsters.
That guy!
There they are. They don't really do a lot of damage. Because I just took 4 hits, I think, and my Gwen shield didn't drop for a bit. And I think I even got hit without shield there, and nothing really happened. So, let's smack these things to bits. I think we can actually loot these as well.
They just keep coming.
We can't hope to defeat them all. As soon as the portal opens, you must jump in after me!
Okay, we will. We also see that we're out of swallow.
2, 1.
Yeah, there we go.
What a relief.
Well, indeed, what a relief. But, sadly, now we are alone. And this is a very weird place. And it sounds like there are creatures in here. There's a portal over there, so we might have to go over there. I'm gonna take a quick look around, because this is pretty cool. I hear larger creatures, but, okay. And I think that's a place of power down there as well. There in the middle of that pillar. So we need to have... We need to get over there.
Vapors don't look terribly inviting.
Okay. Do we have another way then? Because it doesn't look like it.
Damn it, gotta hold my breath.
Okay.
Any longer and I'd have suffocated.
So it's just breath. So I think I can cross this easily then. There we go. We need to get over there, but... Ooh, look at that.
Magic.
We already reached this. There we go, another ability point. And we're going to use those immediately. Because I think we have two even. Yeah, there we go. As you can see, we're pretty stocked up on abilities. And since I have pretty much everything I want from the sign tree, I think I'm going to look towards... I don't actually know general. Oh, no. Yeah, general. But they added a few new ones and I never... bonus from a place of power. I think they added a few new ones in the DLC. Ooh, inventory space increased. You can shoot one additional bolt. Advanced pyrotechnics. Damage dealt by bombs explosion generates adrenaline points. Battle frenzy. Okay. Metabolism boost. Place of power lasts indefinitely. Eating food regenerates vitality for 20 minutes. What? There are a few interesting ones, but I don't really like these because some of these are really, really overpowered. So I'm just going to boost Igni intensity. So that's one I'm going to boost. And then I'm going to start upgrading the fast attack. What a strong attack. I'm just going to start off by upgrading the fast attack. We're going to see later on if we're going to use anything else. Am I going to use that already? Oil targets, poison on blades, and increases maximum toxicity. Well, I might actually use that like this. That lowers my maximum vitality a bit because of my mutagen setup right now. But, well. It's only a small price to pay for extra damage when attacking. So let's just jump down here really quickly and jump back up.
Should avoid those clouds or bolt through them.
I'm guessing we need to go over there right now. Sprint. Because I'm losing health. Okay. Let's eat some sandwiches. I'm gonna meditate as well, because this is I can't even meditate. Because I have no swallow left, which is troubling. Let's sprint through this. Jump over it. So, another grilled chicken sandwich. And then we should be fine. I think we're pretty much where we need to be. Oh, that looks like a cliff. If I go over there, I should be fine for a second. Jump! Jump over, thank you. And now I guess we'll have to beeline it to the portal. Run, 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 run. There we go. now we're underwater! So I'm gonna have to quickly go through the other portal. Luckily there is one. Because we would be fucked otherwise. And now it's freezing. And look at that, True Time and Space. We're still, so that's the name of this quest, by the way. True Time and Space, which is really fitting, of course. Because we're going to different worlds on different moments in time. So, can I break this probably with art? No? There we go. I'm gonna have to use Quen here.
Freeze to death if I don't hide somewhere. And I gotta find that
magic. As you can see, quick. As long as I keep Quen up, I can move through the frost.
If I can just find cover along the way, I should make it to the passage.
And I can use Quen in between to protect myself from the frost. There we go. Just enough power, and then we have that one over there. Oh, I think we have an area over here as well. Because there's a few clues as to what happened here. And I think we can find most of them on the way. So let's put Quen on immediately again, and you'll see it draining again until we find more cover. And then put it on again. More runestones. And there's another bag and a casket. So I don't know. Okay. Oh, that's a problem. Because we're freezing right now.
Light and in a place
I don't
like
know
this,
what just happened because.
Someone must have lit it.
So there's
any luck, it was a certain grouchy elven sage.
A lighthouse over there. I'm gonna.
Snow's up to the rooftops.
Okay.
I wonder how long this blizzard's been blowing.
I think we made a mistake over there and we should have gone through this house, but apparently we didn't. Can I actually light this? So there we have Traveler's Notes. The worst part, the all-encompassing quiet. It seems there is not a living soul around, only snow, snow everywhere, snow as far as the eye can see. Though sometimes we find people still alive in their homes, everyone is hungry, everyone is frozen to the bone, but no one refuses help. They let us warm ourselves by their fire and regain some strength before we move on towards the lighthouse. They say food supplies there have not yet run out. So there were people still alive around here when this was going on. And you might already guess what happened here, since we heard a lot and we actually dealt with the white frost and that it takes over worlds. And this is exactly what happened right here. So this world was taken over by the white frost. So we need to head outside, but I think my coin sign stops being useful right now. Oh no, it doesn't. Okay, okay. So that's not the. Because I think I can even try. Yeah, okay, never mind. Gonna have to run through. And luckily I have a lot of food items, because this might suck otherwise. Cured leather. And then let's drop down. So there's more bodies around here.
Of course. What else? Might have expected this.
And then there's of course Hounds of the Wild Hunt, because they follow where the frost goes. Yeah, burn. The fire even goes outside, so that works in my advantage. Did someone leave notes over here? I don't think they did. Nope, only stuff for me to collect. Okay, that was not what I wanted to do. This was what I wanted to do. And then we're gonna run through here again. I think the GPS gives me a route over here. Can I hide behind the roof? Oh, I can't. Oh shit, I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die. Let's head inside. Okay, that was way too close for comfort. I got kind of fucked there by my marker, because he just gives you the fastest way to get to the lighthouse, but that's of course not the most efficient way to get there. Sadly, we do have a lot of optimometer over here, which is useful in alchemy and the like. So there's another opening over there, so let's go there. Maybe we can find another clue here. Let's head upstairs, and everything's frozen over still, but lunar shards and mostly crafting materials, and let's keep healing, because if that happens again, I'm probably gonna die. Let's put the shield back on and let's see how far we can get through here. Any openings? No, then I'm gonna lose the... Oh. So this is a dull place, and then... Okay. We're pretty safe right now, apparently. It's a really weird level, because it's not really clear what is good and what isn't. Irville's Diary. The 3rd of Berk. This time of year the flowers should be in full bloom, but instead snow covers all. The spring's clearly going to be late. Food will be dear soon, that's certain. So I'm guessing this is 12 days later. It's colder and colder. Snow has been falling non-stop for 37 days now. Okay, never mind. A lot further. Folk don't even bother clearing it anymore. There are no more streets, only tunnels dug through the snow. The 21st of Fame. The snow never stops falling. Our larder is bare. At least we can melt snow to slake our thirst. Though I don't know how long our wood will last. For now, we're alive. So, the white frost is really merciless. It kills everything. It just... Well, the fact is that it just keeps going. You can't stop it right now. Can I stay near the fire? Yeah, I can. Okay, what was that? Oh, hi! Oh shit, another one! There you go. Down it goes. So that's that, and we're right at the lighthouse, so... I'm guessing beeline it towards there? Here we go. Barely enough quench shield to survive. I took a bit of damage, but I'm gonna guess Avallac'h is here.
Took you a while. Did you run into trouble?
A lot of hounds?
No, just taking in the sights. What is this place? Feels like I've been here before.
You have. You fought Eridan's projection here. Before that, Ciri fought here. For you.
What are you talking about?
Ever wondered how you managed to leave the Red Riders?
Many times, but I don't remember a thing.
Ciri came for you. She sensed you were in danger, tore you from the Hunt's grasp, then deposited you in the woods near Kaer Morhen.
Did Eridan start hunting her because of that? Because of me?
Is that how the first Witcher started? When Geralt was found in the woods?
What would it have changed?
Not much, probably. So let's have a little talk about this place.
Where are we? World of the NL?
No. This is Ted Dedda, the time of the end. The world destroyed by the White Frost. Alas, this awaits us all, though at differing stages of our existence.
So calm when you say that.
Eridan succumbed to his knowledge of the apocalypse. Fear rules him now. I'll not commit the same error.
So that's the main reason why Aridin wants to take over our world and every other world for that matter. Because the world of the NL is threatened by the White Frost, and Aridin fears that apocalyptic fate, and therefore wants to take over any other world they can inhabit. So why is Gel so important?
Going after Gels is proving quite a trek, but I still don't know why he's so important.
Aridin differs from the king he killed. Power for its own sake interests him. He has little patience for bureaucracy. He spends most of his time atop his steed, leading the Red Riders. So what does he need in the capital? A good viceroy. Gels is an excellent administrator and an even better plotter. He's the most dangerous individual amongst the NL.
He got any weaknesses?
Yes. He's righteous.
And that's a weakness. So, where did your journey take you? Did you go to any other places than we went to?
I was hoping we wouldn't get separated.
I warned you it could happen.
Where'd your journey take you?
Through a world whose son had just died. I barely reached the next passage in time.
That sounds incredibly dangerous. So, that light on the peak, you put it there?
Light on the peak? Was that you?
I thought it might aid your passage. After all, that is what lighthouses do. Show the way.
Indeed they do. So, thank you, Avallac'h. Let's go!
Doesn't look safe here either. Let's go.
Towards the next portal, I suppose?
Next passage. When will it open?
Shortly.
How shortly? Oh. Jesus, I do have a knack of saying things right before they happen, don't I? I think I did that in Dark Souls a few episodes back, that I was asking for a bonfire as I was walking into a room with a bonfire. But hey, here we go. Different game, different story. Tir Na Lya, Viceroy Gel's Palace. So we have arrived where we need to be. And I think we lost all our combat options for now.
The Palace of Awakening, formerly the Moon Palace. Gel's headquarters.
Well, that was convenient that we ended up here. Follow Avallac'h, and I'm taking points, so Avallac'h. Show me the way! I can't run, by the way.
Beautiful.
I'm glad to know you appreciate it. Elven architecture is a bit more sophisticated than yours.
Why? Because the roofs are crooked? Okay. He's painting a naked elf.
Who's this? And why are they here?
She has
I believe we're
a short attention span.
My tulip. Be a dear and leave us alone. For I think we can agree this matter is between us and us alone, correct?
Yes, indeed.
Queen Anna Spain, Corman Maka, and the Witcher of Rivia. Ketmil.
Hello, Gels. Nice to meet you, too.
Do you like my new model? Something of Lara Doran about her, wouldn't you agree, Grievan?
Her height, perhaps. Nothing more.
I see I've touched a tender spot.
Yeah, I noticed that as well.
So let's change the subject, shall we? Care for a drink?
Yeah, of course. Let's make this pleasant.
Got any vodka? Oh yeah, I keep forgetting you don't touch that filth, disgraceful as it is.
I must admit, you appearing here, quite the surprise, Witcher.
Well, I'll take that as a compliment. And there are,
incidentally,
a few red riders.
Interesting writings. Choice of allies. Do you think Avallac'h is honest with you? Just curious.
Huh. No, but for now it doesn't matter.
No. But honesty's not a facet of your species, so quit spewing bile. Won't gain you anything.
I detect a shadow of impatience in your faces, it seems. So what brings you here?
You, actually.
I've come to tell you who killed our king.
You've gone through a great deal of trouble to reach me, so I must believe you've put equal effort into preparing this lie.
You shall see the truth. You will dream it.
You've been a neuromancer.
Yes, Corrine. Corrine Tilly.
My intuition was correct. This will be interesting.
So will you join us for a little trip back to Novigrad? This way, please.
Better believe it. This way, please.
Witcher Geralt, a true man of action. Might I know where we're going?
To the world of the Enshay. Directly this time.
Let's go, before any guards show up.
And, is there any explanation? Oh, look at that. He's a veritable Picasso, isn't he? I find it funny that there's absolutely no explanation of why we can get back directly from Tirnalia. And couldn't on the way there.
I take it I needn't introduce our guest.
Greetings, Cyril. So it's true. The Swallow has befriended the Fox.
There's naught you can do to make us turn on one another.
Avallac'h blackmailed you. Do you not remember? Tried to force you to warm our king's bed. Treated your body like a side of pork.
I remember. But I also remember what you advised Eredin do with me once I was caught. And I remember what the Red Riders did at Kaer Morhen.
I didn't come here to argue. The proof you promised, where is it?
You will see it. In your dream.
Ah, yes. The Oneiromancer. Visions that cannot be fabricated. Do you wish to show me how Eredin murdered our king?
Yes, we will.
Am I to incite the NL against Eredin? Call for revolution? And proclaim Avallac'h our new king?
No. You'll do what you want.
You'll do what you want. If you decide to continue serving the Regicide, so be it. Wouldn't even be surprised.
And I think that touched a nerve.
Have your oracle summon dreams of my king's last moments.
We shall all dream them, to make certain there are no misunderstandings.
Why not?
Because this is actually really, really interesting. Hello, Corrine. There she goes again. Visions can be so artistic, can't they?
The king is dead. Long live the king.
Hello, Eredin. And well, girls. What is your decision? Or your opinion, at least. I think he's a bit stunned. Hello? Hello?
You must face him on your terms. In this world. In a place of your choosing. It's your only chance.
There we
go. Save Skellige and find the Sunstone. With it, you will summon the Nargothrond. Eredin will come too.
Thank you, girls.
Should he call for reinforcements, no NL will answer.
You have done the thing most just. A new portal to Tirnalia will open. I shall stabilize it and you will return. Come with me.
Wait, what? There's a direct portal right now? Oh, for fuck's sake. Those portals are as convenient as, well, story devices go, I suppose. So we have our plan. We need to find the Sunstone. Yep. Hi, Ciri. Geralt indeed needed a hug.
Just as well. Could have been bluffing. Might have just said that so we'd let him go. Damn it. We should have pressed him.
Calm down. Avallac'h knows him better. We'll hear him out when he returns.
Speak of the devil.
Geralt's worried.
Literally.
He believes we let girls go too easily.
Just want to be careful.
Can never be too careful.
Agreed. Yet I do believe girls will keep his word, withhold support from Eredin.
Seems to me you have a plan. Care to share it with us?
Once we find the Sunstone, aided by your sorceresses and their magic, we shall draw Eridan's ship to a bay along the coast of Undvik. We will wait in ambush, lay a trap. When the King of the Hunt arrives, we will spring it and kill him.
Just like that?
Sounds like a
defeating
plan.
Defeating Eridan will be no small feat, but we will accomplish it.
Gather everyone and we'll meet at the port. Then we sail to Skellige.
There we go, we have our next step. What was that? That was some weird acknowledging nods. There we go, through time and space, completed. And of course final preparations was already completed, but now we actually did everything there was to be done. And now we have a new quest, battle preparations. So yeah, we're not done preparing just yet. Now that we have a plan, we need to prepare for that specific plan. And therefore we need to meet Avallac'h on the ship to sail towards Skellige. But of course, before we do that, I'm gonna take a little break. So if you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give the thought to subscribe to my channel, because any new subscription is really, really appreciated. So thank you guys enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or stream. Goodbye.